Hello friends, today we will be reviewing the movie Run. Run is a thriller film that was released in 2020. The film was directed by Aneesh Chaganty and written by Chaganty and Sev Ohanian. It stars Kiera Allen and Sarah Paulson in the lead roles. The characters in the film are Chloe Sherman. Chloe is the main character of the film, a young girl. She has various health issues and is dependent on a wheelchair. She is raised by her mother, Diane Sherman. Diane is Chloe's mother. She is introduced as a caring mother who attends to all of Chloe's needs and raises her. However, Chloe starts noticing strange behaviors from her mother and begins to question who she really is. If you're ready, let's move on to the film now. Chloe undergoes surgeries when she was a baby and has lifelong health conditions that prevent her from being a fully healthy individual. These conditions include arrhythmia, hemochromatosis, asthma, diabetes, and partial paralysis. Diane is a very involved mother who diligently keeps track of Chloe's needs, medications, blood levels, and schoolwork. Chloe, on the other hand, is determined, hardworking, and always hopeful. Finally, Chloe has reached the age of 17 and eagerly awaits her college results. She passionately researches the locations of all the universities she wants to attend, filled with excitement and ambition. When Chloe one day rummages through grocery bags to steal some candy, she discovers a medication with her mother's name on it. Chloe was extremely surprised because she had no knowledge of her mother taking any medication. In the evening, Diane brought her the medication and gave it to her as if it was Chloe's medication. Chloe mentioned that she saw the medication in the morning with her mother's name on it. Diane brushed off the issue, saying that the name on the label didn't matter and that it was just a receipt. Chloe, unsatisfied with her mother's explanation, decided to examine the labels of other medications as well. When she removed the labels of the medications with her own name on them, she discovered that underneath, her mother's name was written on the labels. Curious to find out what the medication was for, Chloe got out of bed at night and quietly made her way to her mother's computer. She typed the name of the medication into the search engine, but suddenly the internet connection was lost. Chloe, despite all the setbacks, remained determined to research the medication. While her mother was watering the garden, Chloe randomly dialed a number, and a man answered. She asked him to look up the medication called trigoxin. When the man did so, he informed her that the medication is used for heart palpitations. Chloe inquired about the color of the pill, and the man said it was a small, red capsule. However, the medication at home was a green and white capsule, not matching the description provided by the man. They decide to go to the movies together, and while at the cinema, Chloe tells her mother that she needs to use the restroom and leaves her side. She leaves under the pretext and immediately goes to the pharmacy. She asks the pharmacist about the purpose of the medication. When the pharmacist asks for whom it was prescribed, she gives her mother's name. The pharmacist apologizes and explains that due to privacy policies, they cannot answer that question. Chloe insists that it's a game and she made a bet with her mother, managing to get the answer, albeit reluctantly. The medication's real name is Ritocaine, and it is used for dogs. Its purpose is to numb the dog's legs and induce partial paralysis. When Chloe asks about the effects of this medication on humans, she receives the same response. At that moment, Diane enters, clears the area, and without showing it to anyone, she administers a sedative injection into Chloe's leg and immediately takes her home. When Chloe regained consciousness, she found herself at home. When she attempted to confront Diane and ask for an explanation, she realized that the door was locked, preventing her from reaching her mother. Using two wires, Chloe managed to pick the lock of the door, but to her dismay, the door still wouldn't open. She realized that Diane had placed an obstacle behind the door to prevent her from opening it. Chloe jumped out of her own room's window and broke into Diane's room by smashing the window. This allowed her to remove the obstacle in front of her room. To descend, she attempted to use the system that would lower the wheelchair down the stairs. However, Diane had cut the cables of the system. Chloe thought of a solution, but besides jumping off the stairs, there were no other options. She first threw the wheelchair down the stairs and then rolled herself down the stairs. Due to the fall and the prolonged absence of medication, Chloe realized that she could actually feel her legs and control them. However, she was not fully capable of walking or running, so she quickly got into the wheelchair and attempted to move away as fast as possible. While fleeing, Chloe encountered Tom on the way and pleaded with him to take her to the police. At that moment, Diane approached from the opposite direction and claimed that her daughter was mentally unstable, blaming the medication for affecting her balance. However, Tom didn't believe Diane and remained determined to take Chloe to the police. He helped her into the car, but as he was about to close the door, Diane came from behind and injected a sedative needle into Tom's neck. When she regained consciousness, Chloe found herself in an unfamiliar place. She looked around and noticed a letter inside a trash bin that caught her attention. As she opened the letter, she discovered that she had actually been accepted to university. She realized that Diane had kept this information from her, wanting to keep her away and prevent her from pursuing her dreams. As Chloe continued to explore the room, she came across a box with Diane's name on it. Curiosity got the better of her, and she decided to open it. Inside, she found a childhood photograph of herself, but she wasn't in a wheelchair, despite believing that her condition had persisted since infancy. As she delved further, she discovered a death certificate stating her own name and the time of death as 2 hours and 11 minutes. She couldn't believe what she was seeing. She continued to search and found a torn newspaper article. The article revealed that a newborn baby had been kidnapped. In that moment, she realized that Diane wasn't her real mother. Indeed, the baby we saw at the beginning of the film was Diane's own child, who tragically passed away 2 hours and 11 minutes after birth. Diane had made the decision to switch her own deceased baby with Chloe. After learning all of this, Diane entered the room and expressed a desire to talk to Chloe. She claimed that everything was true, that Chloe was indeed sick, and that everything she had done was for her own good. Diane even went as far as proclaiming herself to be the best mother in the world. She attempted to make a deal with Chloe, hoping for things to go back to how they used to be and for Chloe to forget about all that had happened. However, Chloe found this proposition absurd and rejected it outright. Unable to accept rejection, Diane prepared a mixture and filled it into a syringe. She believed that by injecting Chloe with this concoction, she would forget everything and become her baby forever. However, Chloe, crawling, managed to escape into another room and locked the door, seeking refuge. Diane was about to enter the room, and Chloe noticed the medications around her. Fed up with Diane's lies and not wanting to be trapped by her anymore, Chloe attempted to end her life by ingesting agricultural insecticide. Diane promptly took her to the hospital, where they performed gastric lavage to wash out her stomach. When Chloe regained consciousness, there was a nurse by her side. She tried to communicate and explain the situation, but she couldn't speak as there was an endoscope in her mouth. She pointed to a pen, indicating her desire to write down her thoughts. The nurse provided her with a pen and paper. However, an emergency patient arrived, and the nurse had to leave the room to attend to them, leaving Chloe alone. Taking advantage of the situation, Diane entered the room and dismantled all the devices. She immobilized Chloe by strapping her to the wheelchair and then proceeded to kidnap her. While escaping from the hospital, the nurse noticed and immediately alerted the security personnel. They apprehended Diane at the southern exit, near the top of the stairs. Diane attempted to reach for her weapon and handed it to the security personnel, but they acted swiftly and shot her in the left shoulder. Diane fell down the stairs. After 7 years, Chloe went to the hospital to see Diane. Diane was unable to walk, speak, or respond. Chloe talked about her own life, and then she placed a pill in her mother's mouth. Just as Diane had been giving Chloe medication that wouldn't improve her health for the past 7 years, Chloe was now returning the favor to her mother.